Hi. In this video, now that you know what apportionment is, we're going to talk about the different methods and the steps and some of the historical context that was going on at the time of the formation of the US government. The four methods are Hamilton's method, Jefferson's method, Webster's, and the Hill-Huntington method that is still used today. Okay, then we'll talk about these first two steps, which are the same for all the methods. Before we do that though, it's important to acknowledge the historical context of what was going on at this time. We had Native Americans who were on the land before the colonists arrived and were subsequently pushed into smaller and smaller amounts of land. And then we also had slavery and both the racism aspect of slavery and the free labor part aspect of slavery were really built into the United States economy and government. And so it's really important to go back and look at this history, because if we don't understand it, we won't be able to change it to make things fair for all. So there's a little bit here at the bottom of this page. I encourage you to read that. And then also in our textbook, we have, this is in section 5.1, where we talk about apportionment. We have some historical context. Now, this was written partly by me and partly by Tila Foxworth, our race and racism instructor at Southeast Campus. We have so a few little timelines, a little timeline of Native Americans, what was happening with them or to them, and then also a timeline of slavery that kind of goes throughout this section in between the different methods and when they were implemented. So the reason we're putting this in here is to show how all these racist policies like segregation, racial profiling, police brutality, mass incarceration, redlining, and voter suppression, all these things continue today to limit the freedoms and rights and economic prospects of African Americans. And we're putting this in here so that we can show how the past has contributed to the systems that we have today. And those of us with privileges need to work to dismantling those systems so that we have equality for everyone. And also with the death of George Floyd, there's even greater awareness of the systemic racism than ever before, both in healthcare outcomes, in jobs, in economics, and pretty much everything. So I really encourage you to read through this history. I'll just flip through a little bit of the textbook here. We have talking about the formation of the United States, Native people that were on the land, talking about the Constitutional Convention and how the government was formed. Then we go a little bit more into apportionment. You'll recognize that from that previous video. And then another thing I want to show you is that under each method, each person that we talk about, Hamilton, Jefferson, and Webster, we have a little story about their relationship to slavery under each person. So I hope you find that really interesting and read that. And now I'm going to go back to our notes here, and let's talk about the first two steps. Okay, so remember we have we're trying to divide a certain number of items or people among groups of different sizes. So the first step is, first we take our total population and we divide by the number of items we have, or if we're talking about our number of representatives, we take our total US population and we divide by the number of representatives we have. This is called the divisor. Okay, so we'll be using this word a lot, the divisor. What this means, what this represents, is the number of people each person, each representative should represent. Okay, now it's going to be a decimal. Because we have different groups of different sizes, nothing is going to come out even, okay? This is almost always going to be a decimal, okay? The second step is then we take the population of each group and we divide that by the divisor that we got in step one, and that will be our standard quota. Now that will also almost always be a decimal, okay? So this is going to be our initial, this is usually going to give us our initial number, okay? So in the next videos, I'll break down where we go with the rest of the steps from there. But these two are the same for every method. So I'll see you in the next video.